Birds that have adapted to life at sea spend their lives in the air, the surface, in the upper layers of the open ocean, or along shorelines. Shore, littoral, based birds rarely range far from land, and some visit the coast only at certain times of the year. Others are pelagic, often remaining at sea for months and returning to land to breed. Unlike land birds, many pelagic seabirds breed in large colonies on islands and cliffs, deserting them when the breeding season ends. There is no such thing as a typical sea bird, although pelagic birds share many adaptations for life at sea. These include webbed feet, highly waterproof plumage, and glands that get rid of excess salt. Most terrestrial birds have hollow, air-filled bones, an adaptation that helps to save weight, but in diving species, such as penguins, the bones are denser and the airspace is reduced. Some plunge divers, including gannets and pelicans, have air sacs under their skin. These cushion the impact as they hit the water and help them to bob back to the surface with their prey. Compared to these marine species, shoreline birds show few specific adaptations for life in or near salt water, but, like all birds, they have bills specialized for dealing with different kinds of food. Birds live throughout the world's oceans and shorelines, from the equator to the poles. Fewer than 200 species are truly pelagic, meaning that they ply the oceans. These oceanic birds include albatrosses, which have wingspans of up to 11 feet, 3.5 meters, and much smaller species, such as shearwaters and terns. Although they feed on sea animals, their true habitat is the air. The sooty tern, for example, hardly ever rests on the water and may spend its first 5 years entirely on the wing. Food is widespread but localized and hard to locate in open oceans, so most sea birds live closer to land. Most diving sea birds feed in the shallow waters over continental shelves, while rocky coasts and mudflats are key habitats for waders and gulls. Estuaries are important habitats for coastal birds. Their muddy silt often harbors numerous worms and mollusks, accessible at low tide. In the tropics, mangrove swamps attract birds for the same reason. They also have the added bonus of trees, in which birds nest and roost. Marine birds have evolved several ways of hunting their food. Most spectacular are the plunge divers birds such as gannets, boobies, and brown pelicans, which slam into shoals of fish from heights of up to 100 feet, 30 meters. Diving sea birds also include many that cooperate from the surface, such as cormorants and penguins. Emperor penguins typically dive to 490 feet, 150 meters, but have been recorded as deep as 1,755 feet, 535 meters, the greatest depth for any bird. Many oceanic birds, such as albatrosses and petrels, hunt on the wing, snatching animals or scraps from the surface. Kleptoparasitic birds, such as frigate birds, which harass other birds into disgorging their catch, also hunt on the wing. Coastal birds often probe for food in the shallows or along the tide line, but skimmers slice through the water, holding their lower mandible underwater while in flight, a remarkable technique that works only if the surface is flat and calm. Marine birds can range over a huge distance in their lifetime. Some, such as the northern gannet, disperse over wide areas of ocean, return to isolated colonies to breed. The dispersal instinct of northern gannets is strongest in young birds and slowly declines during the 4 years that it takes them to mature sexually. From then onward, adults congregate at their colonies in spring and summer, dispersing again when their chicks have left the nest. Many other birds, such as the red phalarope, migrate between distinct summer and winter ranges. During their migrations, they can be seen on passage between their two homes. Once they reach adulthood, all seabirds have to come to land to breed. Some species nest on their own, but many form large colonies, often because secure nesting sites are few and far between. Cliffs and islands are favorite locations, as they offer the best protection from predatory mammals. Petrels and shearwaters nest in burrows or fallen rocks, but most sea birds lay their eggs in the open using little or no nesting material. Compared to terrestrial birds, they have small clutches. Cormorants often lay 3 or 4 eggs, but many other marine birds, such as albatrosses and puffins, lay a single egg each year. These birds are often long-lived, but their low reproductive rate makes them vulnerable to environmental problems, such as oil spills or climate change. This is one of the most widespread sable ducks, ducks that have narrow beaks with serrated edges, like the teeth of a saw. All these birds dive for fish, using their specially adapted bills to grip their slippery prey. Like other sawbills, the red-breasted merganser has an elongated body, a long neck, and orange-red legs. Males have a metallic green head and shaggy crest, while the female's head is rust-colored, with a less flamboyant crest. These birds breed near fresh water, but spend the winter on coasts, where the water is less likely to freeze. Females build a nest in dense cover, or in a tree hole, lining it with down. They lay up to 11 eggs, raising a single brood a year. Red-breasted mergansers are shot in some parts of their range in order to protect fish stocks, although there is little evidence that they actually do much harm. This heavily built duck is one of four closely related species, all from South America, that have lost the ability to fly. Like other steamer ducks, it has mottled gray plumage, yellow legs, and a robust, yellow-orange bill. It feeds on mussels, crabs and other small animals, diving among kelp beds to find its food. If threatened, it paddles noisily across the water with its wings. A behavior known as steaming. Despite its dainty appearance, the snow petrel is one of the world's most southerly breeding birds. This entirely white petrel nests on ice-free cliffs in and near Antarctica, to within 680 miles, 1,100 kilometers, of the South Pole. It picks food from the surface of the sea, rarely straying far from the polar ice. Flocks of snow petrels are often seen sitting on icebergs. Equally at home in fresh water and at sea, the great cormorant can be found across a vast swath of the world, from Greenland to Australasia. From a distance, its plumage looks jet black, but close up it has a greenish metallic sheen, with white patches that vary between local races. Like its many relatives, it fishes by pursuit diving and its feathers are only partly waterproof. After feeding, it rests with its wings spread apart to dry. Great cormorants have a strong, direct flight, with steady flapping interspersed with short glides. They can often be seen in small groups, skimming just above the surface of the sea or following rivers inland. They nest on rocky ledges and in trees, making a platform out of seaweed, flotsam, or twigs, and the females lay three or four greenish-white eggs. Great cormorants are sometimes persecuted by anglers, particularly in trout fishing regions, but they remain highly successful. With its vividly marked bill, bright red feet, and red and black eye patches, this is the most colorful sea bird in the North Atlantic. Like other members of the auk family, it feeds by pursuing fish underwater, using its strong, stubby wings to swim. In the air, it flies rapidly on fast beating wings, skimming over the waves as it returns to its nest with food. Atlantic puffins breed in large hilltop colonies digging burrows in coastal turf. The parents take turns incubating the single egg, and they both help to feed the developing nestling. Instead of regurgitating food, as most seabirds do, they return with small fish held in their bills, carrying about six fish simultaneously, arranged alternately head to tail. Each nestling is fed continuously for about 6 weeks, after which the parents abandon it and head out to sea. After going without food for several days, the young bird crawls out of the burrow and flutters down to the sea after dark. Puffins disperse out to sea in fall, when they lose the bright bill colors that make them so conspicuous during the summer months. This highly streamlined bird with its gleaming white body and black-tipped wings is the most striking plunge diver in the North Atlantic. Northern gannets roam the seas with a distinctive pattern of flapping and gliding flight, attacking shoals of fish by diving from heights of up to 100 t, 30 meters. They breed in crowded colonies on rocky islands and clifftops, laying a single egg each year. Juveniles take 5 years to mature, gradually losing their brown plumage. During that time, they roam far over the ocean before returning to their native colony to breed. This is one of six species of boobies, a group of plunge diving birds, closely related to gannets, that often have brightly colored feet. The blue-footed booby is brown with white undersides. Its feet are grayish-brown in juveniles but brilliant turquoise-blue in adults. Blue-footed boobies often feed in flocks, hitting the water almost simultaneously when they locate a shoal of fish. Smaller than gannets, they are able to fish close, inshore, sometimes diving into water less than 3 feet, 1 meter, deep. They nest in small colonies on offshore islands, laying their eggs on the ground. With their extraordinarily long wings and slender bodies, frigate birds are unrivaled experts at gliding flight. The five species all have glossy black plumage, strong, hooked bills, and small, webbed feet. The males also have a bright red throat pouch, which they inflate during courtship displays. Despite weighing less than a large gull, the great frigate bird has a wingspan of up to 71 halves of a foot, 2.3 meters, allowing it to glide for hours while making only the merest flick of its wings. As it flies, it observes other sea birds as they feed, then pursues them to steal their catch. Frigate birds also hunt their own food, such as flying fish, snappings it up from the sea's surface. They nest in coastal bushes, where they make flimsy nests out of twigs. Commonly seen inshore and in harbors, the brown pelican is the heaviest sea bird that fishes by plunge diving. Groups of birds often fish together, skimming over the waves before rising into the air, folding back their wings, and hitting the water with a spectacular splash. The pelican's throat pouch balloons outward underwater, scooping up prey, which it then swallows at the surface. This legendary sea bird has the largest recorded wingspan of any bird, at up to 111 halves of a foot, 3.5 meters. It is restricted to the windswept southern oceans, where it feeds mainly on squid, snatching its food from the surface of the water. It is capable of remaining airborne for weeks at a time and frequently follows ships, soaring over the waves on its stiff, outstretched wings. The wandering albatross takes up to 11 years to mature, and during that time it gradually loses its juvenile plumage, becoming all white except for black markings on the tips and trailing edges of its wings. These birds nest on remote islands, typically breeding in alternate years.